Thank y'all so much. Well, y'all, I've been doing music now for a living for about 12 years, and still working on becoming an overnight success. Y'all got my guitar up there? Can you hear it? I could use a little more in the monitor and a little less vocal. So, here's what I have learned about the music business in those 12 years of how to make it big. I don't know if it's worth it to even take my advice, but if you want to be as rich and successful as I am in the music business, then here's how to do it, ladies and gentlemen. It goes something like this. First you buy an old second-hand amp with the knob that sticks. You plug a cheap Fender in, then crank it to 10, and you learn a few haggard licks. Then you play every day for about 9 or 10 years, writing songs for your girl and blowing all your money on gear. Then you talk to a drummer who's a friend of a friend at church. He's got a buddy who's been learning the bass, so you get together after work. You play together 6 months till the band is tight. Book your first big gig on a Friday night. Step up to the mic and pray you remember the words. Then you sing about love, or maybe love gone wrong. And you do a little drinking, do a drinking song. Make everybody dance, everybody smile, everybody feel good for a while. And when you're done, way to go, you finished step one. Next you borrow 10 grand from your uncle and you make a CD. Little known real life fact, I actually borrowed 17 grand from my grandparents to make my first CD. And I did pay it back to them in 1 year. By the skin of my chinny chin chin. So next you borrow 10 grand from your uncle and you make a CD. Good luck paying him back, cause it's a modern day fact, anybody can get it for free. You spend your time online making virtual fans, shopping for a band van while you work for the man. Do you book enough gigs you can turn in your 2 weeks? Then you sing about love, or maybe love gone wrong. And you do a little drinking, do a drinking song. You make everybody dance, everybody smile, everybody feel good for a while. But when you're through, that's pretty good, but that's just step two. Step three, glue your hands to a steering wheel. Step four, eat fast food every meal. Step five and six, fire the original band to buy a new van. Step seven, burn out and give it up. Step eight, try again, cause it's what you love. Step nine, you finally break through to the big time. That's what this feels like tonight. And then you sing about love, or maybe love gone wrong. You put your whole heart and soul into every song. You make Letterman laugh and Leno smile. Stack your rewards up in a pile. And guess what's next? They all call you an overnight success. Yep, you're an overnight success. Hey, and all it really took was 15 years of blood, sweat, and tears. You know, on second thought, maybe you should have just tried out for American Idol. Thank y'all. Well, I tell you, you know, there are more important things in life than success in your career. And I have been blessed with a lovely wife who's my best friend. And I've here recently, we've been blessed with a little baby boy. I call him a baby. He's 2 and a half now. So I guess at some point I got to quit calling him that. But this is a song that I wrote to welcome him to the world. And so it's about 2.5 years old now, this song is. At the time, I was we had just moved back to Texas from Nashville, and I was living in my wife's grandparents' house, and I didn't know anybody here in Texas. I didn't have any gigs. I didn't really have a job, and we were taking care of her grandparents while living there for free, so we were just living really cheaply and not making hardly any money, and we could barely afford to actually have the baby because, you know, the doctor's bills and everything. So we pinched our pennies and we saved our money and we were able to actually afford to go to the doctor and have a baby. But this is a song that I wrote to welcome him to the world. Happy birthday, boy. It's bright here, ain't it? Look at you, more beautiful than any picture ever painted. Welcome to this world, son, with all its hopes and fears. It never will be. It's better now you're here. Rest here in my arms a while. Let me hold you as you dream. Lord knows if I only could. I can promise you this, son, you'll always have enough. You weren't born into money, but you were born into love. Life ain't easy, son. You'll learn that lesson well. But the way your mama looks at you, it's clear you're worth every tear that fell. I don't know what you'll find, boy, as you travel down this road. But as long as we're alive, you'll never travel it alone. Rest here in my arms a while. Let me hold you as you. If I only could, I'd give you everything. But I can promise you this, son, you'll always have enough. You weren't born into money, you were born into love. Son, you weren't born into money. But you were born into love. Well, here's a song I wrote for my wife. This was after we had been married. It's called I Am What I Am. If I were an astronaut, I'd bring you back a moon rock. You could put it on a bookshelf with all of your other whatnots. If I were a painter, I'd talk you into posing nude. Yeah, then you'd get paid to lay around all day and let me look at you. Now, if I were a hitman, I'd take you cruising in my unmarked van to kill some time, sipping wine on the beach in a faraway land. If I were a preacher, I'd say a few extra prayers so you could sleep in on Sunday and still be squared away with the man upstairs. But I am just what I am. Honey, I was born a music man. So I do what I know how to do. I string a few chords together and sing about loving you. Now, if I were an architect, I'd take my handy-dandy pencil set, design you that two-story log home with a split-level wraparound sun deck. If I were a lumberjack, I'd help you climb up the tallest tree, show you the little baby eagles that ordinary people never get to see. But I am just what I am. Yeah, I was born a music man. So I do what I know how to do. I string a few chords together and I sing about loving you. All right, these are the bonus verses that aren't on the CD version. Y'all get them because you're special. Oh, yeah. Goes like this. If I had a green thumb, I'd plant tomatoes when the spring comes. Yeah, then you wouldn't have to panic about buying organic. You could just pick you some. If I had a PhD in self-help psychology, I'd write a book about how you helped me live in the now and find inner peace. But I am just what I am. I was born a music man, yeah. So I do what I know how to do. I string a few chords together and sing about loving. Spend all day just kissing and cuddling, writing these songs that are all about loving. Kylie, come on up here, will you, sweetheart? Y'all got to see Kylie Rae Harris earlier, and she sings a mean old harmony part with me on this next song, so I'd like to invite her out. Thank you, Kylie. You may have, this story got told like over and over and over on Troubadour, Texas.
Yeah, over and over.
Over and over. But
it's that good.
We met. We didn't get to hear each other's music, really, but we traded CDs or something, or I gave her a CD, and then next time I saw her, she was like, hey, can I sing with you on Pablo Maria? And I was like, you know, thinking to myself, that's kind of an emotional tune, and you screwing it up would probably screw it up, you know. I didn't know. I'd never heard her sing before. How was I to know? But anyway, I said, sure, you know, I'm the kind of guy that, I don't know, kind of laid back anyway. So I'm like, sure, come on up here and sing. And I was not expecting it to be good, and it was awesome. She'd been listening to my CD, and she sounded then that very first time that we ever even sang it together, just like she's going to sound tonight. And ever since then, it doesn't seem quite the same if she's not there singing it with me. So Kylie Rae Harris, y'all. Pablo Escobedo took Maria for his bride in the dead of winter, 1885. A bitter snow was falling as a dozen ragged men surrounded the little chapel, trapping Pablo in. They called out, surrender, or we'll burn the whole place down. And Pablo whispered, death can't hurt me now. Stay here, my Maria, and remember me this way. Then he kissed her lips and they dragged him away. And she heard him calling to her, sweet Maria, can you hear me? Muffled echoes up and down the frozen canyon walls. Maria, how I love you. Till the lonesome sound had nowhere else to go, swallowed in the January snow. Oh, 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 oh. Silence fell, the solemn priest said, God will avenge my child. Maria just stared right through him, hollow-eyed and wild. Stumbling into the muddy street, she lifted her eyes to see the twisting, awkward silhouette now still beneath the tree. No one dared to touch her as she left her lover there, ran down toward the river with the wind whipping her hair. The snowflakes swirled behind her like the finest flowing train, and the north wind moaned and whispered as if it knew her pain. And she swore she still heard him calling, sweet Maria, can you hear me? Muffled echoes up and down the frozen canyon walls. Maria, how I love you. Till she reached the edge of the river far below and leapt into the January snow. Oh, 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 hey. If you're ever down in Texas in a January snow, and you hear a mournful whisper in the north wind as it blows, you may feel the lonesome presence of a lady all in white, weeping in the distance, just out of your sight. And you may hear him calling to her, sweet Maria. Muffled echoes up and down the frozen canyon walls. Maria, how I love you. Till the lonesome sound has nowhere else to go. And is swallowed in the January snow. Thank y'all so much.
Well, y'all, it is difficult to follow a song like that. Yeah. And my strategy is to just do something totally different.
And I know for sure that there's at least a couple of people in here that have been doing a little drinking tonight. So I'm going to finish you guys off with a drinking song. And I'm telling you, you guys are in for a real treat with Austin Cunningham, who's finishing up the show. He is the real deal and one of my favorite songwriters. Anytime you, if you want to get me to do a show, just tell me that Austin Cunningham's doing it. And there you go. I'm in. But we're gonna get this going here. And if you know it, sing along, you know. Called 99 Bottles of Beer on the Wall. Texas style. Well, on a day hot enough to make the devil cuss, I walked into a bar so thirsty I was spitting dust. Barkeep asked me, what'll it be? I said, what you got? He said, well, let's see. We got Lone Star, PBR, Rolling Rock, Shiner, Bach, Moose, Drew, Low Duels, Heffenbison, Ziegenbach, Keystone, Coors Light, Coors, we got Red Stripe, Amstel, Amsterdam in the tall can, Michelob, Miller Lite, Guinness by the pint glass, Doppelbach, Lager, take a swaller, cause it's going fast, oatmeal, stout, a lot of line and Kugels, open up your wallet, no time to be frugal, there's 99 bottles of beer on the wall, 99 bottles of beer, take one down and pass it around, 98 bottles of beer on the wall, yeah. Y'all keep practicing that chorus, and I'll have you singing with me at the end. You're going to have 100 times to practice it, so. Well, y'all, needless to say, I was pretty impressed as he handed me an ice-cold beer from a chest. I said, not bad for a hole in the wall. Barkeep grinned, said, that ain't all. We got Rio Grande, River Octagate with a twist top, Dos Perros, Dos Equis, Foster if you're Aussie, Bud Light in the new Zane Williams koozie, a dozen wheat beers on tap if you're choosy. Got Heineken, Killians, Bats and Becks, ice cold Coronas with the limes in the necks, Yingling chilling with old Milwaukee's best, Sam Adams and that ain't even half of the rest of them. 98 bottles of beer on the wall, 98 bottles of beer, take one down and pass it around, 97 bottles of beer on the wall. And I get Yeehaw! You know, now my parents are hardcore Church of Christers, and they do not drink at all. So to sing along to this song, you don't actually have to drink alcohol. You can still just sing it, you know. But I was actually in this part of writing the song that I started to run out of beers that rhymed, and I realized I was only on 97. I was like, man, what kind of a fix have I gotten myself into? And so I had to come up with something a little different to wrap it up, and here's what I did. Well, I settled down with my favorite brew. I ordered me another, and before I knew, it was 2 a.m. and I was under a table being choked by some dude that smelled like a stable. And finally, I was able to throw him through the screen door, pick up my hat off the hardwood floor, get on back to the barkeep's daughter who was putting Papa Top on the jukebox, dancing nonstop and sipping on a beer that I bought her. We were drinking it like it was water. There were cowgirls everywhere wearing their pretty hair down to their derriere. And there were two more bottles of beer on the wall. Two more bottles of beer. Took one down and passed it around. One more bottle of beer on the wall. Sing it with me. One. We raised it up high, and then we drained it dry. You. And there were no more bottles of beer on the wall. Oh, y'all sound pretty.
Thank you so much.
But you know what, y'all? It was... It was a Thursday night in Texas, and everybody knows that a Thursday night in Texas is just as wild as a Saturday night anywhere else. So after all the beer was gone, we made a critical decision, and we started on the Cuervo Bacardi Gold Margarita Straight Tequila Jim Beam George Dickel, and we wet our whistle with a single malt scotch peach schnapps in a jello shot. Captain Morgan, pour some more of them ciders, sliders, flying tigers. Dr. Pepper for the designated drivers. Everclear, Absolute, and Amaretto. I don't remember much, but I never will forget those. Singing with me, 99 bottles of beer. There ain't nothing finer than an ice cold shiner at the Texas Roadhouse. Ka-ching! And 99 bottles of beer on the wall. Thank y'all so much. A few chords together and sing about loving you. Now if I were an architect, I'd take my handy dandy pencil set, design you that two-story log home with a split level wraparound sun.